Hello students, we have seen in the previous lecture five stanzas of the poem. I have given you the homework also to write the central idea of these five stanzas. Have you done them? Now, I think that you have in your mind how the rhyme scheme is there, rhyming words are there, what the poet has said in each and every stanza. You have read it very seriously, no? That means you have prepared well. Now we'll have to move the questions. Okay, see, open text and see page number 4, English workshop. Now what is there in English workshop? I have told you that the exercise based on the content or the poem, the questions are asked in this. Now we'll concentrate and we'll take one by one how the questions were asked. You'll have to give me the answer then. Okay, are you ready then? Okay, now the first question. Choose the correct alternative and complete the given sentence. The two, three alternatives will be there and you have to choose correct one. I will take one example and you have to do remaining. Okay, first example is, according to the poet, dash dash are brought by each new day. Two options are there, new beginnings or new endings. What do you think? Yes, new beginnings. Okay, so the sentence must be like this. According to the poet, new beginnings are brought by each new day. Like this, can you do remaining three sentences then? Then the second question. Find and write the rhyming words from the poem. We have seen the rhyming pairs in the previous lecture, no? That means already in each stanza, make, take, like that the rhyming words are there, you'll have to find it out. Can you do that? Next question. What is the rhyme scheme of the poem? Choose the correct one. That means they have given the variety type of four rhyming schemes. And amongst that, one is correct one. You know, that is ABCB. So you have to write ABCB answer. Okay. Now the next question. Fourth one. Column A with column B you have to match. That means they have given the lines here and in the second B column they have given the examples of figures of speech. The line first is decisions I must make. This is inversion figure of speech, so you'll have to mention it. Second, please open up my eyes. This is apostrophe, no? So you have to mention it. Travel down the darkened road. So alliteration is there. And last one, I can choose to take the road of life. This is metaphor. So you have to write the direct answer. Okay, next question. Fifth one is planning an interview. So what are the points they have given? How and why you have to take interview? See, lot many topics are there. Lot many well-known persons are there, you have to take their interview. So first one, fix the format or structure of the interview. How much or the length size of the interview. Do's and don'ts, rules and regulations of the interview. Types of questions, yes no questions and WH questions you have to ask. That means variety type of questions must be there in that format. Next one they have given, set the 10 questions. Yes, no, and WH. For example, what is your name? How are you? WH questions. Are you satisfied? Or have you faced any difficulties? Like that you have to ask questions. So these are yes, no questions. So like that you have to prepare. The structure or format is given here. According to that, they have given the points also. So you have to write only name of the interview. That means consider that Sachin Tendulkar has came to your school. Or probably Lata Mangeshkar, you want to take the interview of her. So give the title and name of the interview. Next topic, the person's name, venue, where you are taking that interview, day, time, duration, how much you want to ask. Then all these yes no questions and WH questions mixing. Then background, conversation, what you want to converse with them. Avoid personal questions. And next and the last one, avoid very casual and cheap and vulgar language. That means how you want to take the interview, these are the rules stated in this format. So can you take and write the interview of any person then? Any player, any singer, any whatever the favorite person you want, you have to take the interview of him or her. Okay. Now the next question, compose a short prayer in English. So you have to prepare your own poem or compose any four lines on your own, and that must be prayer. And again, see whether the rhyme scheme, rhyming words are there. Okay, and the last question they have given, but not the least, they have given one chart on page number 6. Here, look around in your vicinity, your family, friends, neighbors are there, and three columns are there: family, names, and here special or extraordinary things they have made. Either from family member, your father, mother, brother, sister have got any award or any special thing, you have to mention here, name. Or friends, any one of your friend had, we can say, got the award for what, you have to write the reason. Or neighbor, if he has any prize. And last one, classmates, if your classmate, the name and for what the speciality is there. Like that, you have to fill this chart. Can you fill that? Only one remaining part is there from this on page number 5, that is read the poem and make an appreciation of the poem. So see here, this chart, we'll have to see it very carefully. So how the questions are there in the board, now we'll have to concentrate. Like this English workshop from this text is over. Now how the board will ask the questions on this poetry, we'll see now. Now before going to board exams questions, we'll see what we have seen in English workshop. See 1 to 9, these questions are there. First one, choose the alternative. You have to choose either one. Second one, rhyming words, that is make, take like that. Rhyme scheme ABCB. Next, match A with B, figures of speech. Next one, planning interview or interview. And next one, format of interview. Actually, you have to form that interview. That means in that interview, you will have to ask yes, no questions and WH questions. Okay. And the next one, compose short poem. You will have to compose the poem on your own now. You can do it. And next one, when chart is there, you will have to name the special things, what the persons have special about, what they have achieved. And the last one, the appreciation of the poem, we'll see in detail, because in the board exam it will be asked for 5 marks. So how the questions are there in the board exams, we'll see now. Have you understood this one? So you have to prepare like this English workshop. Now we'll move to the questions asked in the board. Now see how the questions will be asked by the board about poetry section in 10th standard or in SSC board exam. The poetry section is concentrated and it is stated as part 3. That means poetry section part 3 is there. Question number 3A and B is devoted to poetry section. That means whatever the poems are there in the textbook, no students, you have to face these poems for 5 marks each. That means first 5 marks question will be there, and in that 2 stanzas will be stated and you will have to give the answers of these questions. 1-2-2 like that, or 2-2-1 like that, the questions division is there. For first question, question number 3A, poetry section, they will ask 2 stanzas and you will have to answer the questions. Otherwise, second question will be there on the second poem, not the same, but the second poem's 2 stanzas will be concentrated for poetic appreciation or appreciation of the poem for 5 marks. Now, which are the points, those are there in poetic appreciation, and how the questions were there on this poem, we'll concentrate now. See here, a teenager's prayer. Now, this is the homework you have to do. Now, A1 type of question, 1, 2 and 3, that is A1, A2, and A3, these 3 questions carries 5 marks. First question 1 mark, second question 2, and last again 2. First question is called as, A1 is called as, we can say, answer in one sentence or a phrase. Okay, so the question is, what is the age group of the speaker in the poem? What is the age group of the speaker in the poem? This is called as answer in one word or one phrase. Second one, why it is for one mark. A2, why the teenager is praying? Why the teenager is praying? Or you can conclude another, what he is praying for? Or they will ask, probably give the central idea of any stanza which is there printed in the question paper like that. So this question, no, you have to write within 4 lines because this carries 2 marks. So you'll have to write it in detail. Okay. Then A3, give the poetic device used in the poem. Probably they will ask 2 lines and identify the figure of speech. Otherwise, they will state, give any figure of speech or a poetic device used in the poem for 2 marks. Identification 1 mark and how it is used in the poem 2nd mark. That means 1, 2, 2, like that A1, A2 and A3 questions are there for 5 marks. First question is there. Is that clear? Now, the second question, which is very important, you have to make practice much about this. That is appreciation of the poem. त्याला आपण मराठीत म्हणतो रसग्रहण करणे, म्हणजे ती कविता नुसतीच वाचणं नव्हे, मनापासून वाचून त्यातले बारकावे समजावून घेणे. सो रसग्रहण म्हणजे ॲप्रिसिएशन ऑफ द पोएम. नाऊ दिस इज अगेन फॉर 5 मार्क्स. सो फर्स्ट आय विल गिव्ह द ऑर विल सी द पॉईंट्स विच आर देअर. बोर्ड विल गिव्ह द पॉईंट्स अँड जस्ट यू हॅव टू राईट पॉईंट नंबर 1, पॉईंट नंबर 2, लाईक दॅट यू हॅव टू कम्प्लीट दिस. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल write the heading, that is appreciation of the poem. Then first point, title. What is the title? That is a teenager's prayer. Now the poet J. Morse is there. Like that you have to mention the name of the poet. Then first title half mark, poet's name half mark. Then rhyme scheme again half mark, that is ABCB. Then favorite line, probably they will ask 4 to 8, within these, no, they will ask any 2 questions, but you will have to prepare all. Favorite line, it will differ, no, which line you like, probably the student will like different line, but which line you like, you have to mention that line in inverted comma. Okay, next one, fifth, the theme or central idea of the poem. Now this is for 2 marks, because whether you have understood that poem or not, this must be checked by this point, no. What you have understood? तुम्हाला काय कळलं त्या कवितेतनं? यू हॅव टू राईट ऑन युअर ओन. तुमच्या शब्दातल्या 4 ओळी मात्र आल्या पाहिजे. यू हॅव टू मेन्शन इन 4 लाईन्स थीम ऑर सेंट्रल आयडिया इन शॉर्ट ऑफ दॅट गिव्हन स्टॅन्झाज, नॉट द होल पोएम बट 2 स्टॅन्झाज अँड द सेंट्रल आयडिया. नेक्स्ट, फिगर्स ऑफ स्पीच. नाउ इन दोज गिव्हन 2 स्टॅन्झाज, नो विच फिगर्स ऑफ स्पीच आर देअर, इन्वर्शन, मेटाफर ऑर अपोस्ट्रोफी ऑर वॉट नेक्स्ट. You have to identify and name the figure of speech. And next one, special features. Are there any special features or the poet wants to concentrate on special feature, you have to mention. Next one, why I like or dislike the poem. Kadachit avadel kahina avadnar suddha nahi. Tachamulo, you have to mention it. I have liked this poem or not. Like that, why I like the poem, you have to write in your own words. Like that, practice all these appreciation points in your home. Make its practice much so that you can score more. Okay, so like this, in poetry, 5-5, 10 marks question will be there and you have to prepare according to that. So have you understood the poem? Once again, before going, I want to concentrate students that keep listening, speaking, reading and writing of English so that you can score more in English. Thank you for being with me. Thanks a lot and best luck. Thank you.